So this comedian has responded to this line that Kendrick made on the new GNX album. He didn't specifically name any comedian, but basically all the internet was saying, hey, it's this guy. And they were posting clips of it. And so I guess this guy does a podcast. His name is Andrew Schultz. I never heard of this guy. I didn't really know who he was until all this stuff happened. But I guess he does a podcast, and he got on there and kind of responded to Kendrick Lamar on this. And every video that I make about Kendrick Lamar, I always do admit, I'm a fan of Kendrick Lamar, but I do think I'm one of the most fair, unbiased, fans of Kendrick Lamar that discusses stuff about him. And then Andrew Schultz, I don't even know who this guy is, so I can't really be biased to this guy. But I mean, if you're expecting from this video, me just worship whatever Andrew Schultz says or worship whatever Kendrick Lamar says, that's not the case, bro. I'm not gonna have double standards with either of these guys. I wanna address some of the things that he talked about and some of the points he made. I think he had some points that I would admit it is valid, but man, he had some stuff on there that was really weird or just, I don't think it was really fair. I'll start off with the stuff that I think was not really good points. One thing he does, in the beginning, is he talks about, the line was about, not making jokes about black women. He talks about how just rap as a whole is a lot of it can be disrespectful to women, which I think is really not fair. When you're talking about Kendrick Lamar, you're talking about one guy, and then you're just using the genre as a whole, saying all kind of lines from that have been disrespectful. And this is my thing too. I hate when people say, "Oh, rap is all about money, drugs, and B words or something like that." It's like if you want to find songs that is like that, you can. But I mean, if you want to find songs about different stuff, bro, there's so many artists out there with so many messages. You can find other stuff too. It's not all that. So I don't think that's really fair to put, all of just the genre of rap as a point against Kendrick Lamar. I think if you look at Kendrick Lamar's music overall, I mean, there may be some songs he's been on or some lines that it maybe it's sexualizing or you could take it as disrespectful towards women. But for the most part, bro. I think Kendrick Lamar's songs are the opposite of that. I mean, he's got songs Keisha's song or that song "Mother I Sober," about his mother's abuse. I think for the most part, his music is actually respectful to women. And man, the other thing he did that was really weird to me is, bro, he goes on a long rant about being intimate with Kendrick Lamar and that Kendrick Lamar would not be able to do anything about it, bro. He just keeps talking about that, bro. It's like, I know the guy's a comedian. He can just be like, "Oh, it's just a joke, blah blah." I mean, whatever, bro. I don't think that's funny, bro. That's just really weird. That's really weird to go to that angle of things. I guess he was trying to say, in real life, Kendrick Lamar is not threatening. He is a pretty short guy or whatever, and he's not huge and intimidating. The way you want to illustrate that is by saying what he did. I mean, bro, that's just crazy to me. That's really weird. The points I would give him that's kind of valid, he does bring up how he wants to say, Drake was a deadbeat dad or whatever. He mentioned that in that beef, but then, makes songs for somebody like Future that got, so many kids by different women or whatever. And he also brought up something about the people in his team had, supportive of keeping R. Kelly's music on streaming platforms, and they was going to take off Kendrick Lamar's music if they did take him off streaming platforms, or he's worked with artists that have been abusive towards women or they make songs disrespectful towards women. And I won't lie, bro, that is actually kind of a valid point. I hadn't really thought of things like that, but there is sometimes, even in this beef with Drake, although I do think Kendrick Lamar won, there was points in that where I kind of felt there was some double standards in there, some things he would say that I'm almost man, did you forget who you are? You've kind of done stuff that I feel could apply to this. So those things, I will say that's kind of fair. He kind of brought up some hypocrisies there. And then Andrew Schultz also brings up that I guess Kendrick Lamar is working with the people from South Park, either making an episode or making a show. I don't know. I don't watch South Park. I don't keep up with that at all. But he says he's working with them, but these comedians on there have done the same thing that he's attacking Andrew Schultz for, I guess.
I don't watch South Park, but I guess that's also kind of a double standard there.
I would admit, though, those are kind of fair points. Those are kind of valid. But overall, bro, I think some of the things he said, it almost like it just overshadows, you know, the good points you made. Like, maybe you made those, but you never brought up this whole thing about the intimacy with Kendrick Lamar, you know, against his will. Like, maybe that stuff would have went over better, because, like, when you go there, it's like, yeah, I mean, people aren't even thinking about the good points you made. It's like, all we can think about is this crazy freaking thing you said, you know what I mean? So, I don't know. I don't think necessarily Kendrick Lamar needs to respond to this, but it was an interesting response to see him come on there and make some of the angles that he did. Some of them I don't agree with, but he had a few valid points on there. That's all I got. You know, I just wanted to address it. You know, I'm not all the way one or the other. I don't think that he's, like, beat Kendrick Lamar. I don't know if this is a beef they got. You can really call it that, but, I mean, he brought up some fair points, I guess. But, you know, let me know what you guys think in the comments. Like the video if you liked it. Subscribe. I'm trying to get to 200 subscribers. Doing a giveaway once we get there. Appreciate everybody for watching.